have a look into the periodic table, we can see there is a lot of elements. Ada banyak sangat elemen. And each element ni, dia ada pelbagai karakteristik dia. One main thing that we have to look into is setiap elemen ni, ada yang ada isotop dan ada yang tak ada isotop. But how does a scientist actually differentiate between these different type of isotopes? Hi, welcome back to Siri Pensyarah Kimia Awak. In this video, we're going to discuss about mass spectrometer. Okay, apa itu mass spectrometer? Mass spectrometer ni adalah satu instrument yang mana para saintis guna untuk identify different type of isotopes. Yang penting dalam video ni adalah how can we interpret this mass spectrum. Okay, mass spectrum, kalau kita nak tahu, ada dua komponen dekat sini. Yang pertama, mass over charge di dalam dia punya horizontal axis. At its vertical axis, dia tunjuk dia punya relative abundance. Okay, abundance ni, it can be in the form of percentage, it can be in the form of any number. Okay, so how can we interpret this? Daripada data-data yang kita dapat ni, kita akan tengok dia punya average atomic mass. Okay, that's why kalau kita tengok dalam periodic table, the mass number untuk certain element, let's say for carbon, is not exactly 12.00, it's actually 12.01. This is due to the average of all the isotopes of carbon. Okay, how do the scientists calculate this? It is very simple, just by using this formula. Okay, average atomic mass is equal to the sum of quantity multiplied with the mass divided by the sum of quantity. Okay, secara yang saya nak ingat senang, simple saja. Average atomic mass is equal to E kimi EK. And mass dia pula boleh jadi dalam bentuk berunit dan boleh jadi dalam bentuk tidak berunit. Unit dia apa? U ataupun AMU, which is atomic mass unit. Bear in your mind that if the question asks you to determine the relative atomic mass, once you calculate the average atomic mass, you have to compare it with 1/12 over carbon 12. Okay, to make things clearer, why not we have a look at several examples? Okay, let's check out. Example 1. Determine the relative atomic mass of magnesium.
Alright, untuk contoh ini, kita akan tengok macam mana kita nak interpret this data. Okay, yang di vertical axis ni, dia menunjukkan berapa banyak isotop tu yang ada. Well, yang ini 24, 25, dia menunjukkan the variation of isotop of magnesium. So, how do we determine the relative atomic mass? Okay, so to determine the relative atomic mass, the first thing that we have to do is, we have to find the average atomic mass. Average atomic mass is equal to sum of quantity darab dengan mass over sum of the quantity. E kimi EQ. Q ni apa? Okay, nilai Q ni kita boleh dapat dari sini. Ini adalah kita punya Q. Yang di sini kita punya M. As we can see, E kimi EQ is equal to akan dapat nilai dia adalah 24.33. Ini ada unit AMU, so dia adalah AMU. Ini baru dia punya average atomic mass. The question asks us to calculate the relative atomic mass. So, what we have to do is, in order to determine the relative atomic mass, we have to compare it with carbon 12. Is equal to mass of one magnesium compared to 1/12 times mass of one carbon 12. Okay, So kita dah kira tadi, mass of one carbon kita dapat adalah 24.33 AMU, dan kita punya mass of one carbon is actually 12.00 AMU. You can dapat relative atomic mass is equal to 24.33. Tidak ada unit. Right? So this is how you determine the relative atomic mass from a given mass spectrum. Important thing to differentiate between average atomic mass, okay, and also relative atomic mass. Those are two different things.
Example 2. The ratio of relative abundance of naturally occurring of chlorine isotope is as follows: chlorine 35 over chlorine 37 equal to 3.127. Based on the carbon pore scale, the relative atomic mass of chlorine 35 is 34.9689 and chlorine 37 is 36.9659. Calculate the relative atomic mass of chlorine.
The first thing that we have to do is, okay, this type of question is slightly different than before. Kalau yang sebelum ni kita diberi satu spectrum, but right now we don't have any spectrum. We were only given the ratio of the abundance. So kalau dari spectrum senang, tapi kalau dari sini kita kena fikir lebih sikit. So kita tahu bahawa Q untuk chlorine 35 divided by Q untuk chlorine 37 is actually equal to 3.127. So it can be any number here. So what we have to do is, we can just simply assume nilai apa bahagi apa dapat 3.127. Paling senang adalah 3.127 divided by 1 is equal to 3.127. So what we can say here is the Q for chlorine 35 is equal to 3.127. Q for chlorine 37 is equal to 1. Okay, how about the mass? So the mass for chlorine 35 as given in the question, which is equal to 34.9689. Yang ini tidak ada unit sebab ini memanglah relative atomic mass, so you don't have to do anything there. And for mass of chlorine 37, this is equal to 36.9659. Okay, so how do we determine the average atomic mass? Atomic mass is equal to E Kimia. Ni adalah tanda sum lah, tapi cara saya nak ingat Kimia is equal to 35.45. Ada unit tak? Jawapannya tidak. Sebab apa? Sebab di dalam soalan telah diberi nilai dalam bentuk relative atomic mass. Remember, kalau relative tidak ada unit. And the question asks us to calculate the relative atomic mass for chlorine, so we didn't have to do the second step like before. This is because the values that you obtain is already the relative atomic mass. So what we can do is, we can simply write the AR for chlorine, which is equal to 35.45. Senang kan?
Senang kan cara kita nak kira average atomic mass? Make sure you know the difference between average atomic mass and relative atomic mass. Okay, if you'd like to see a lot more example, just click the link down below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye!